Welcome back to NetSuite Super Training. In this lesson, I'm going to be showing you how you log into your NetSuite account if your company has two-factor authentication set up. So first off, two-factor authentication is not something native to NetSuite. It's a general thing which basically uses multiple devices or logins to verify or authenticate that you are the proper person logging into whatever it is, in this case, NetSuite. So I'm going to be using my laptop here. I also have my phone, which I'm going to be using as the second authentication. So let's see how we do this for two-factor authentication. Okay, so first off, obviously I'm at the login page. So I'm going to be logging into my account. So I'm assuming in this case that this is the first time you're logging in and you're going to hit your first interaction with two-factor authentication. When you log in the next time, it will be this process, but a shortening of it. It'll be a little simpler on re-login. So the most complicated is definitely the first time you're logging in. So let's take a look at that. Okay, so we've got this page that's basically telling us an email has been sent to us, right? This at our proper email, which gives us a verification code. So I have the email open here and you can see, just make sure that's the correct one. So let's click on that. All right, so 651301. So let's copy that. So you're gonna go back to your NetSuite page and you're gonna copy that code into this little window. And for this account that I'm logging into, I'm logging in as the accounts payable analyst. So whatever role you're logging into, your company is set that it needs two-factor authentication, and this is how you would do it. You hit submit. Okay, good. So now what it's gonna do is gonna tell you to use an Authenticator app. So this is where your phone comes in. So there's a few different Authenticator apps. There's really two main ones. There's Google Authenticator and there's a Microsoft Authenticator. Those are by far the most commonly used ones. They're very reliable. They're great authenticators. You can use another one, but I recommend you stick with one of those two. So in this case, I have Google Authenticator. So I'm going to open up my phone. Probably can't see that well, but I've got the Authenticator app there at the top. So I'm going to open it up. And so simply all that's going on here is it's saying download one. You can see it says Google Authenticator or Microsoft Authenticator. It points out here that there's also Oracle has its own authenticator. You can absolutely use that. So let's go next. So it gives you this QR code right here. And basically what you're gonna do in your authenticator, once you have to download an authenticator. So whether if you've got an iPhone, go to your app store. If you're on an Android device, go to the Android app store. And you simply download, in this case, let's say Google Authenticator. Once you link it to an email, it's gonna tell you, okay, do you wanna add your first code? It'll give you a page where it simply says, add a code. So you can maybe see that on my page here. And I'm gonna say add a code, and it'll give you an option. Do you wanna enter a setup key or QR code? I'm gonna hit QR code. And it's gonna say, can I use your camera? You say yes. And then you're actually just gonna put it over your page and it should automatically scan that QR code and recognize and pull up a code. So your Authenticator app will now show you just this one code at the top and it'll give you like a little time window that's counting down. So you have to make sure that you put in the code within that time. So as long as that window is still going, you have that time to put in the code. So you can see on my page here for NetSuite, I have the window here to put in that code. So I look at my phone, my timer hasn't gone down quite yet. So I'm putting in the code from my timer. And before that timer runs out, I'm gonna hit next. Good, so I've now officially and successfully logged in using my second factor authentication. It gives you all these additional backup codes. You can certainly print that and have that as a backup in case you have problems with your two-factor authentication in the future. But that's very, very unlikely, and it's just a precaution. So you can ignore this if you want and go on to next, and you will arrive here at your homepage. I'm gonna ignore the security questions for now. I covered that in the other video. So we're now on our NetSuite homepage. Now, every time after this, again, depending on your company settings, but every time you log on after this, if it's set to have a two-factor authentication every single time, you will come to a page where it'll say, plug in your two-factor authentication. at which point you go to your phone, you enter or open your app for Google Authenticator, the Oracle Authenticator, or Microsoft, and it will have that NetSuite code. It will always have a code there with a little timer running down. So you just wait until you have a nice big timer, enough time to put in. You'll input it into your NetSuite login. You put the code in, you'll hit next, it'll bring you to your homepage. It takes about 10 seconds to do for any normal login. So that's it for two-factor authentication login. I'll see you in the next video.